It's more fun with Mommy. It's more fun to learn.
Hello, a beautiful day, everyone. Welcome to another quarter of exciting and interesting lessons of music grade 10. I am your teacher Janina, your teacher for today. I know that everyone is ready to explore the world of African and Latin American music. So here we go! For today's lesson, you are expected to
Number 1. Describe the historical and cultural background of Afro-Latin American and popular music. Number 2. Analyze musical characteristics of Afro-Latin American and popular music through listening activities. Number 3. Explore ways of creating sounds and a variety of sources suitable to chosen vocal and instrumental selections.
The lessons during the first quarter gave us a better understanding of the music of the 20th century. This era helped to shape music into what it is today. Before we proceed to the lessons for the second quarter, let us check what you have learned. I am going to name a musician of the 20th century and identify his musical style or movement.
Number 1, we have John Cage. The answer is chance music. Number 2, Claude Debussy. The answer is Impressionism music. Number 3, we have Arnold Schoenberg. The answer is Expressionism. Number 4, Edgar Varese. The answer is Electronic music. And number 5, we have Igor Stravinsky. And the answer is Expressionism music.
Very good! Now I can say that you are ready for our next lesson. Let's go! We will begin with the music of Africa. Music has been a vital part of the lives of Africans. It was primarily performed during rituals in the monumental parts of their lives like birth, marriage, death, and war.
African music is also one of the most influential styles of music in the world. Its highly energetic and rhythmically challenging beats are quite universal. The music of Africa is the product of the diverse history, topography, and unique musical heritage of more than 50 countries. It is the result of the fusion of traditional and European influences, which was a result of the colonization of Europe to the majority of the continent until the 19th century. The first one is Afrobeat. Afrobeat is a term used to describe the fusion of West African with Black American music. Listen to the sound of Afrobeat. Another one is apala or akpala. Apala is a musical genre from Nigeria in the Yoruba tribal style to wake up the worshippers after fasting during the Muslim holy feast of Ramadan. This is an example of apala music.
Hey, Omojo, ti o ba le jo ba lo ngo rara o.
Pato poli to mo mamojo.
Ewu agbada ko se bi jo ba lo ngo.
Ama ko bi e bi e bi awo mo ni.
Boy si ijo ba lo ngo teri e.
Ije jo ni dandogo.
Mo cha ko ra pata.
Lori ijo ba mi ngo. Elebe mo ni.
And the last one is Kwasa Kwasa. Kwasa Kwasa is a musical style that began in Zaire in the late 1980s, popularized by Kanda Bongoman. In this dance style, the hips move back and forth while the arms move following the hips. This is the sound of Kwasa Kwasa.
As a young girl, Louis Vuitton, with your mother on a sandy lawn.
How did you find the traditional music of Africa? Well, African traditional music is mainly functional in nature, which is used primarily in ceremonial rites such as birth, death, marriage, succession, worship, and spirit invocations. We're done with the traditional music. Let's also talk about the vocal forms of African music.
The first one is maracatu. Maracatu is the combination of strong rhythms of African percussion instruments and Portuguese melodies. This form of music is being paraded along the streets by up to 100 participants. Listen to the sound sample of maracatu.
Negro sofreu, negro apanhou, foi pro mato e o quilombo formou. Ganga zumba zumbi. Alagoas, Pernambuco, Palmares, Praça do Carmo.
Alagoas, Pernambuco, Palmares, Praça do Carmo.
Quilombo, barriga zumbi.
Zumbi, Palmares, Quilombo.
Quilombo, barriga zumbi.
Zumbi, Palmares, Quilombo.
Ganga, zumba, zumbi.
Ganga, zumbi.
Ganga, zumba, zumbi.
Ganga, zumbi.
Ganga, zumba, zumbi.
Ganga, zumbi.
Ganga, zumba, zumbi.
The second one is blues. Blues is one of the most widely performed musical forms of the late 19th century. The melodies of blues are expressive and soulful. The slaves and their descendants used to sing this as they worked in the fields. Here is an example of blues music. Next vocal form is soul. Soul is a popular music genre of the 1950s and 1960s, which originated in the African American community throughout the United States. It combines elements of African American gospel music, rhythm and blues, and often jazz. This is how soul sounds like. Another is spiritual. Spiritual originated in the United States and created by African-American slaves. It is also known as Negro spiritual. It became a means of imparting Christian values and a way of venting their hardships as slaves. Here is the sound sample of spiritual form. And lastly, call and response. Call and response is likened to a question and answer sequence in human communication. The slaves used to sing these songs while simultaneously doing all their tasks in a day. Listen to this example.
Kade misawa, misikuba, misikuawale, bwedi kade, kado dibo, bosuma bre, bosuma sa, bofe alau, bokwesi alau, bwede makpre, bose dun, bota dun, jema bokamo, makwese gusiron, bokwiti, malale kwiku, bosi akra.
Well, alright everybody, yeah. I just got back from my tour.
Okay, are you now starting to appreciate their music? Wait until you hear the sound of their musical instruments.
We are going to discuss this according to their classification of sound. We will start with the idiophones. Idiophones are instruments that produce sound with the vibrations of the body of instruments itself. First one is agogo. Agogo is a single bell or multiple bells and is considered as the oldest samba instrument based on West African Yoruba single or double bells. It has the highest pitch of any of the bateria instruments. This is the sound of agogo. Second one is shekere. Shekere is a type of gourd and shell megaphone from West Africa, consisting of a dried gourd with beads woven into a net covering the gourd. This is the sound of shekere. Now let's go to the membranophones. Membranophones produce sound by the vibration of a tightly stretched membrane. First one is body percussion. Body percussion refers to African music using their bodies as instruments. Their body can be used to produce sound by clapping their hands, slapping their thighs, pounding their upper arms or chests, or shuffling their feet. Wearing of rattles or bells on their wrists, ankles, arms, and waists enhances their emotional response. Here is an example of body percussion.
Okay.
next instrument is talking drum. Talking drum is used to send messages to announce births, deaths, marriages, sporting events, dances, initiations, or war. It is believed that the drums can carry direct messages to the spirits after the death of a loved one. This is the sound of talking drum. The third one is djembe. Djembe is one of the best known African drums. It is shaped like a large goblet and played with bare hands. The body is carved from hollow trunk and is covered with goat skin. Listen to the sound of this instrument. Next classification is the lamellophone, where the sound is produced by the vibration of tongues of metal, wood, or other materials. We are only going to discuss one instrument in this classification, the mibira or kalimba thumb piano. It is a set of plucked tines or keys mounted on a soundboard. It is being played by holding the instrument in the hands and plucking the tines with the thumbs. This is the sound of mibira.
Amazing musical instruments, right? Indeed, African music has a very wide range of musical instruments.
The music of Africa has also reached different parts of the globe. A lot of Africans were transported to Latin America for work and brought their music with them. As we go through our lesson, you will see how the music of Africa was fused with the music of Latin America. The music of Latin America is the product of three major influences: indigenous, Spanish-Portuguese, and African. Sometimes called Latin music, it includes the countries that have a colonial history from Spain and Portugal, divided into the areas of Andean region, Central America, Caribbean, and Brazil.
Let us start our journey towards Latin America with the three most popular Latin American music.
The first one is samba. Samba is a dance form of African origins around 1838, which evolved into an African-Brazilian invention in the working class and slum districts of Rio de Janeiro. Its lively rhythm was meant to be executed for singing, dancing, and parading in the carnival. This is an example of samba music.
Samba! Samba de Janeiro!
Another one is san. San is a fusion of the popular music or canciones of Spain and the African rumba rhythms of Banto origin. Originating in Cuba, it is usually played with the guitar, contrabass, bongos, maracas, and cleves. Its most important legacy is its influence to present-day Latin American music. particularly as the forerunner of the salsa. Listen to this sample. The last one is salsa. Salsa is a social dance with marked influences from Cuba and Puerto Rico that started in New York in the mid-1970s. Its style contains elements from the swing dance and hustle, as well as the complex Afro-Cuban and Afro-Caribbean dance forms of pachanga and guaguanco. Here is the sound of salsa.
Just like in Africa, they also have a wide variety of musical instruments.
The varied cultures developed in Latin America gave rise to different types of wind and percussion instruments. Their instruments were classified into three. You will learn more of these classifications as we go through our discussion. First classification are the Aztec and Mayan instruments. Aztec and Mayan instruments are instruments that were being played during the Aztec Empire and Mayan civilization. Aztec and Mayan people are people who lived in southern Mexico and northern Central America. First instrument is Teponaztli. It is a Mexican slit drum hollowed out and carved from a piece of hardwood with designs representing human figures or animals, to be used for both religious and recreational purposes. This is the sound of Teponaztli. Another classification we have is the Incan instruments. First on the list is ocarina. Ocarina is an ancient vessel flute made of clay or ceramic with 4 to 12 finger holes and a mouthpiece that projected from the body. This is how it sounds like. Last classification is the Andean instruments. Let's start with siko. Siko is a side-blown cane flute that is played all year round. This is the sound of siko.
What a very interesting musical instruments! Don't you know that the music of Latin America is very danceable? This is so exciting! Starting with cha-cha.
Cha-cha is a ballroom dance originated in Cuba in 1953 that was derived from the mambo. The Cuban cha-cha is considered more sensual because it contains polyrhythmic patterns. Here is an example of cha-cha. Another form is rumba. Rumba is a popular recreational dance with Afro-Cuban origin. It is normally used as a ballroom dance where a couple would be in an embrace, though slightly apart position, with the rocking of the hips to a fast, fast, low sequence. Listen to this example.
Let's move and gay and get it on.
Third form is bossa nova. Bossa Nova is the slower and gentler version of the Cuban samba, originated in the 1950s. It is the Portuguese term for new trend. This genre integrates melody, harmony, and rhythm into swaying beat and is often sung in a nasal manner. Antonio Carlos Jubim is the foremost international figure of Bossa Nova, while City Navarro is his Filipino counterpart. This is the Bossa Nova sample. Another is reggae. Reggae is an urban popular music and dance style that originated in Jamaica in the mid-1960s. It is instantly recognizable from the counterpoint between the bass and drum downbeat and the offbeat rhythm section. Bob Marley is the best-known proponent of reggae who hails from Jamaica. Listen to this sound sample. That ends our episode for today. I hope you've learned a lot about the music of Africa and Latin America. We will see each other again in the next episode for more exciting topics. Have a great day, everyone! Goodbye! I am your teacher, Janina, your teacher in music. Bye!